Hello, I'm Dani. Welcome to the workshop. In a series of previous videos, I have shown you how to import STL files in SolidWorks, how to work with them, to repair them, and to convert them to SolidWorks features. Because there are already a lot of videos, I have created a special playlist about STL and you can find it here. Today, I am going to show you how to modify the STL before converting to features so you can remove unwanted faces or facets from it. If we want to modify the STL before converting, then the normal import is not suitable and we have to use ScanTo3D. With ScanTo3D, when we are importing the model, we can delete facets that we don't want to have. And so we start the mesh preparation wizard, go to the step in which we can delete faces and remove geometry we don't want. In this case, I will use the lasso tool to pick the facets or most of the facets I want to remove. You can see clearly where the other surface is starting, the hole in the fillet in this stone, which I want to remove. Once we have picked the majority of facets, I can start collecting the rest, the smaller round. To include to my current selection, I use Control and mouse click. For a long time, I didn't know how to repair this when I select something I don't want, and it's quite easy. For this, you need Alt and mouse click button to remove part of your selection. Once we are ready with the selection of all the facets, we just delete them. Even if we had picked some extra by mistake and see it later, it's not a big deal. I also have done this here, if you can see. The mesh preparation wizard will fix that for you, so don't worry. Just go to the next step. The next step we skip, and maybe you would like here to smoothen the boundary, which is the bottom slide. You go to the next step in which the wizard would tell you you have two holes and it will repair them. After that, we will have the complete stone and all we have to do is launch the surface wizard in automatic relation because this is organic shape. And then we should find the best fit for our model so we can have it nice and smooth as end result. If for some reason it's not turning out the way you want it, you can go to this menu to edit the lines and you can adjust it in a way it's working for you. In some cases, you must change the lines because it will give you faulty faces. With changing the lines, you can fix that. In my case, I'm doing this purely to have a more smooth surface at the end when I'm ready. What you can do here in editing the lines, you can add new line, you can move points like this. Moving points is a bit more tricky. See, when you have this green sphere, this means you can place the point there. And this is how you adjust the lines. Once we are ready with this step, we can move forward and create our feature. And as you can see, as end result, we have pretty well looking stone without a hole in it, and we can start from here and build whatever we want. So I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did so, maybe you should use the like button to show me that you like what I do. Also, if you want to keep up to date with my channel, don't forget to subscribe and see you next time. Bye bye.